CNBC TV 18 learns from sources that Tata Global Beverages is all set to undergo massive restructuring of their portfolio to sell non-branded businesses in parts. Porinju Velayat, the MD and portfolio manager at Equity Intelligence, now joins us. Porinju, good afternoon. You have been a bull on Tata Group's consumption stocks. I remember you telling me that these stocks are at inflection point. But thoughts on Tata Global, if indeed we have this kind of restructuring?
Good afternoon, Anuj. It is true. I have been talking for some time about Tata Global Beverages and Tata Coffee. Basically, the consumer, the branded business of Tata Group. Because I have been surprised, you know, how these companies can be at such a low valuations, or why these companies are not performing in spite of inheriting such a huge brand, a huge marketing network all over the country. You know, they have everything in place, but somehow the management that has failed to really take it to the next level. But it is a question of time that it will happen. In fact, the restructuring of the consumer business and the focus of Tata Group on consumer business has been discussed quite some time now, maybe more than 6 months' time. Promoters, the management has, they have talked about it in the public domain. So that is the reason I have been extremely bullish on these stocks, and I want to disclose. We are holding Tata Global Beverages and Tata Coffee, myself personally and in portfolio management. So these stocks, I think they have got a long way to go perhaps. You know, if you have the belief in the business what they are doing, and the restructuring can be, it could be a trigger.
So, you know, one element of the restructuring, as we understand, at least the options that are being discussed for Indu, is the sale of the non-branded business and also maybe the prospects of a merger between Tata Global and Tata Coffee. Would that make sense to you?
Not to me. To the investors, it makes a lot of sense. it makes a lot of sense, you know, too, because now the size is very important, the operational synergies. And they are basically into beverages, coffee and tea. And, you know, the Tata Coffee has a very valuable 8 o'clock coffee as an American brand. And the kind of estates what they own. Everybody knows the fundamentals of these companies. Nobody need to really, you know, explain further. These are very old companies. And I think they are like blue chips. But these companies are traded at one time the sales. It's almost like commodity companies. Because of the Tatas. Tata's the management made it that way. If it was a dynamic, good management, this would have been at least three times the sales.
Okay. So, Porinji, you said Tata Global and Tata Coffee is something that you're bullish on. Porinji, the other space where you have been bullish on is Future Group stocks. You know, I wanted to discuss Future Consumer also with you. That's up 9% right now. What next for this particular group?
It's moving as expected in the last 3 years, and I think it will continue to move the coming next maybe at least 2-3 years with this kind of a momentum and of creation of wealth, because they are into very, very futuristic, good business model, and India has a long way to go in this kind of business, and we have huge potential. Now that, as we always discuss, the structural changes happening in the economy, you know, that is the inflection point I have been always talking. It is going to accommodate a lot of smartly run business, you know, where they can grow 5 and 10 times going forward. So investors should try to identify the pockets of opportunities in a changing India, a dramatically changing Indian economy and its structure. Which are the opportunities getting opened up? Which are the troublesome problems at the pockets? You know, there are some companies, some businesses are getting into trouble. That is also equally important to watch and exit from those businesses. Because, you know, stock picking, see, it is true that everywhere in the world, every country and economy, at any given point of time, it's easy to say stock picking is the game. But here, we are in a very peculiar situation. Stock picking should be the only game. That's the kind of inflection point we are at. Many companies will get destroyed. Many companies are getting into a sweet spot, a great operational environment, and they are going to create huge wealth for investors.
Okay, final question then, Porinju, on one of your favorite stocks, Biocon. What next? 14% higher today.
Biocon, yeah, we exited some time back. We booked profit, as I told you, on one of my chats. Now, Biocon is again, it's around 20,000 plus market cap. It's a beautiful company. whatever happening, you know, there was a negativism in pharma generally in the last more than one year. But India has a huge advantage when it comes to quality pharmaceutical manufacturing. So we will continue to be ruling the world in that aspect. So which companies are going to do well? Investors should be very careful. There are, when you see overvaluation of some businesses, should be careful, because one US FDA warning can make it down by 20-30%. So it's again a very dynamic world. I feel we are not holding Biocon now. But Biocon seems to be, it's a great company in making, if things go on well. But there are again risks. I think last 2 days somebody is speculating on a potential outcome of some meetings going forward about, I think, biosimilar being approved in by FDA. I don't know much about that. But there are many biosimilar products in the pipeline, and the company is having various aspects of business, which all seems to be good. I'm not recommending this stock, but I like the business model.
Okay, Purinjo, thanks a lot for your time. Always good talking to you.